you're always told that absolute power corrupts absolutely, and I'm sure that's meaningful, but we don't run into absolute power very often in our lives. What people wield in the world is mostly Baroque, kind of almost barely detectable power that is. And this is, you know, one of those places where you realize there's a like a little thread of sadism just out there, searching in a way for, you know, for contact with someone else's masochism or persecution complex, and that's the sort of thing novelists get very interested in. November 17th, 1991. Dear, thank you for the opportunity to read As She Climbed Across the Table. Jonathan appears to have talent with language, and so it is heartbreaking that those people got to him first. I suppose these misguided results can be laid entirely at their feet. The young man can't have had any idea what he was getting into. I took the liberty of showing it to, and he wholeheartedly agrees. The case is a hopeless one and a true loss. Yours regretfully. Editors bounce things all the time, but it's very different from the rejection letters that you accumulate as an aspiring writer, which is what I was still doing at this point. Those are some sort of weird, you know, it's like a Twilight Zone tribunal of masked faces. They're in some high court, and you're trying to exist. You just want to exist. And they're saying, I'm afraid not. I'm afraid you don't. You know, I'm sorry. We thought it over. The funny thing is, you know, I wanted so much, and at the same time, rejection letters themselves, back then, I collected them. I sort of loved them. They were also proof that I existed. It was like they were trying to tell me I didn't exist, and they'd accidentally confirmed my existence anyway. Well, you wrote something, and it was enough for us to reject. So that's, you know, that's kind of good. You know, and maybe the reason the letter stayed with me was that in its weird, elusive way, it was saying, things should be themselves only, not muddled up with other things. And of course, I've been a great muddler, and I already was trying to muddle, I thought, in brilliant ways, and was adamant that this was like worth doing. And so to be told that it was not just, you know, oh, this isn't working, but not to be done, was very, it was a little private war I felt I was fighting.